Good evening. It is chillingly reminiscent of 2011. Parts of Grantham evacuated as a raging inland sea surged through the Lockyer Valley community. Six people tonight remain trapped on the roof of a house. Rescuers can't reach them because the weather is just too bad.
Grantham going under. A wall of water pushing past and beneath homes where people sheltered inside. Cars almost covered these houses, their residents, in its unforgiving path. Hours earlier, the flood siren sounded and they knew what was coming, told to evacuate before the inland sea arrived.
We're just waiting for the boat to come. They've gone past a couple of times, but they're checking on a few other people. But yeah, I've still got like 2 depths before the water comes into the house.
It's an eerie feeling of deja vu for the Lockyer Valley. Swift water rescue crews going into Grantham to rescue anyone stranded. We are 2 kilometres south of Grantham. Emergency services are desperately trying to get a helicopter to those who are trapped, but right now the weather is simply too poor. After 2011, the lowest-lying residents here were relocated to higher ground, a move that today may well have saved lives. The owner of the floating cafe in Grantham packed up the business this morning, concerned it could float away again.
2011, the whole cafe went underwater. Got picked up off its stumps and then it went, like hit the trees there, got stuck there, a bit of water went through the cafe, they managed to re-stump it and put it all back together.
In Drayton, the moment bystanders became heroes, wading through waist-deep water to rescue a man clinging for life on the front of his ute.
By the time we got to the bank, the car was no more, so he's a very lucky man. A couple more minutes out there and he wouldn't be no more with us.
The men threw him a rope and pulled him to safety, fighting the raging floodwater to get back to land. The rain all came from Toowoomba, the Garden City, with more rain than any Green Thumb wants, 170 millimetres before 9 a.m. Rooftops were safe, shops weren't.
Poor old Rose again.
Floodwaters raced down roads and spilled into CBD stores.
I just had bad thoughts of 2011 coming through again.
So did drivers on the range. All that water washed down to Withcott, sweeping through the main street, surrounding homes and businesses at the bottom of a drenched city on a hill. Mother Nature left her mark on Helidon too, these residents saved from raging floodwaters.
Well, it just came out so fast, it was just like walking along the grass.
I walked across to the kitchen window and all I could see was water everywhere. And so Pete said, come on, we've got to get out.
Now on higher ground and hanging on to hope.
You worried about what you might go home to?
Oh yes, definitely. I've got a cat there that I'm very worried about.
People living at the Helidon Spa Resort decided to evacuate.
Oh my God, it's broke. The riverbank broke.
These scenes, these sounds, too close to the horrors of 2011 for the residents here. As we go to air tonight, rescuers are in Grantham trying to reach those people who are trapped. A resident I spoke to in the past hour, she says that the water is still rising. We expect those people to be brought here just outside of Grantham once they are rescued, but with helicopters unable to get in and the water so strong, it will be a difficult mission. I'll have updates for you throughout the bulletin.
And of course, we're all hoping for the best. Thanks for that, Emily. Meanwhile, flooding is now expected here in the Brisbane River, starting on tomorrow's high tide. The Weather Bureau says minor levels, nothing like 2011, but also the Bremer at Ipswich, which could exceed moderate flood levels tomorrow. And still, this deluge continues.
The front wheels hung on, but not for long. The station wagon floating away at Zillman's Crossing in Caboolture, a family inside, had been freed. There were fears people were missing as a day at the park turned dangerous. 2 emerged from Caboolture's Centenary Lakes Park. Swift water rescue crews went in to search for others, but it was a false alarm. The saturation created by dangerous, slow-moving thunderstorms parked over Greater Brisbane, the north side, south side and west.
Since many catchments are now saturated, there is a high risk of dangerous and life-threatening flash flooding.
Parts of the southeast experienced nearly half a metre of rain since midnight. Hundreds of roads are cut, including the state's lifeline. The Bruce Highway closed in two spots. It's likely to remain so for 24 hours, leaving Caboolture and Moray Field isolated.
The best thing our community can do to help us at the moment is to not go out in this weather and to stay where they're safe.
Because suburban creeks are now raging torrents. At Second Avenue Bridge in Marsden, drivers gambled halfway through before realising there was no way through.
Just go the other way. There's two or three different ways for him to get around.
At Greenbank on Goodner Road, hundreds of motorists took the risk. At Springfield on the Centenary Highway, so many ignoring warnings, making more work for rescuers.
With barely any breaks in the rain, the workload for these swiftwater rescue crews today has been absolutely relentless. They get done with one job like they've just done here at Stony Creek, and it's pretty much straight off to the next one.
Close to 50 rescues and counting.
Any one of those jobs is too many. It puts our personnel at risk.
Visibility was poor as rain poured. Rockley's Stable Swamp Creek is usually a trickle, today a torrent.
Torrential, yeah. Normally it's, yeah, calm. Now you just see all the debris flying through and, yeah, it's crazy.
120 kilometres northeast of the city.
The very top end of the eastern branch of the Brisbane River.
All flowing downstream. Joel Dry, 7 News.
Authorities are scrambling with 19 of the southeast's 25 dams at or over capacity. And in an unexpected move, SEQ Water will tonight start releases from Wivenhoe Dam. The level is rising far more rapidly than anyone expected. This morning it was below 60%, now it's almost 68%. Dam operators had said they wouldn't release water until it reached 80%, but with 2011 still fresh in their minds, they're no longer prepared to wait. In a week, the combined water grid has risen by more than 8% to 76%. Quite incredible. Let's go to Caitlin Steadman now. Caitlin, the Albert River is also rising tonight at Logan.
Max, here at Wolfdene, the water is coming up rapidly with a minor flood warning now in place. The river is about to hit 5 metres and could soon exceed 6 metres. It's also now a major flood warning for the Logan River with many roads now closed. But despite all the rescues, all the warnings, so many drivers continue to risk floodwaters. Here, a woman ignored road closure signs to charge ahead, only to realise she couldn't make it. She had to call for help and is now safe. But exhausted and increasingly frustrated, rescue crews are urging others to stay out of the water.
Thanks, Caitlin. Well, Georgia Costi, the Redcliffe Peninsula has also been in the firing line.
Yeah.
Max, there's heavy rain falling here right now and it is coming down quite quickly. The risk of flash flooding is quite high. Already roads are cut, creeks have broken their banks. Winds have also been picking up. Gusts of around 46 kilometres per hour have been recorded. The Weather Bureau says these kinds of conditions are extremely unusual for this area, especially at this time of year. And there's plenty more rain crossing the coast, so residents are being urged to stay inside.
Thanks, Georgia. Well, let's go further north now. In Gympie, the Mary River is right now rising and flooding the centre of town, and it's tipped to reach heights not seen in more than 20 years, triggering a race to evacuate shops in the city centre.
They knew the waters would come, but watching it is still devastating.
For the town and the businesses and the people that are stuck, so it is quite a scary experience.
Bridges into Gympie went under this afternoon. Locals know what's next, the CBD. Shop owners didn't bother sandbagging. The Mary River's force is too great, expected to peak tonight, bringing a flood as severe as the town's 1999 disaster. The warning sounded the starter's gun on a race to higher ground. Shipping containers trucked in to get stock out.
Council came down earlier and expected it to be 20, 21 metres, which is halfway up this
this wall.
In Mary Street, the heart of the town, frantic business owners were up at 4:30 this morning.
I heard the rain and it was really heavy and I thought, no, this is not good.
They cleared out offices, saving what they could.
We didn't expect it. It's taken everybody by surprise, to be perfectly honest, because there's been so much rain so fast.
More than 300 millimetres of rain fell in the Mary River catchment overnight. It's now sitting at more than 16 metres and rising, heading towards a major flood level with a peak of 22 metres.
22 metres, we're completely submerged, so we're getting out as fast as we can.
Residents in rural properties have been cut off.
This is second major flood incident in about 6 weeks, and no doubt they're feeling the pain.
At Amamore, it was a race to evacuate livestock and to find a missing family. Swiftwater crews couldn't reach them, instead calling in a chopper. Life Flight picked up five people and a dog who were stuck in a home surrounded by rising waters. The fate, Gympie, now awaits. The waters here this evening are rising incredibly quickly. As you can see, the water is up to almost the ceiling of these businesses in the CBD. There's a roundabout under that water. That went under in just over an hour this afternoon when the Mary River floods. It floods incredibly quickly, but the locals know that and they are prepared. They're ready for what's to come, but also incredibly nervous of what could happen overnight and just how high the river will rise.
And such a massive cleanup ahead. Thanks for that, Anna. Rosanna Kingston is in Pomona for us tonight, where residents are being warned this rain could get worse.
We're being told as much as 300 millimetres could fall over a six-hour period, bringing with it the risk of life-threatening flash flooding. Emergency services are on high alert. There's already been dozens of rescues across the Sunshine Coast, and most likely there will be more to come. They must be exhausted by now. Still, there's swift action in these Swiftwater rescue crews to the rescue of another couple stuck in floodwaters. The pair was plucked from a bitumen island, piled into a boat and paddled out.
I don't think I've been frightened before like that. It was quite frightening, terrifying.
Catherine and her husband had stopped for a rest last night.
There was literally one paddle, sweetie, one paddle there. Thought, fine, went up, parked. 5 hours later, woke up to keep going. Water everywhere. I was just, look at it.
At Kooran, more than 200 millimetres has fallen since 9 a.m. Udlow and Maroochydore have seen 129 millimetres. At Coolum, 128. Nowhere for guests to park, Australia Zoo was shut. Beaches have been battered, many of them closed. The hinterland hammered. This is Whopper Dam roaring. Imbul, the rainfall split the road in two. After waiting hours for the Diagula Highway to open, drivers heading west quickly became stuck again. The road into Kilcoy quickly going under. And then cut off.
Probably just going to have to crash. Probably in the car, maybe, I imagine. I imagine that's what everyone else would probably be doing if this water doesn't, go away.
In Kooroy, residents were told it would get worse. They just didn't think it would be this bad.
I've lived here for 25-odd years. I've never seen it like this before.
Now pondering what's still to come. Rosanna Kingson, 7 News.
The Gold Coast has so far escaped the worst of the flooding, with the biggest impact felt on wild, dangerous and now closed beaches. But in the hinterland, an entire community is tonight isolated after their only road out was washed away.
Upper Coomera Road is the only access for residents in Illinbar and the Flying Fox Valley, and the road is gone. The causeway collapsed, undermined by a relentless torrent of water.
All of a sudden, just sort of built up and, washed away. The rest is history.
Residents stuck upstream are safe on high ground, but plenty of people were caught unprepared.
Well, Thursday's normally shopping night, so we're running low. But more so medicines and that, like everybody on this side can't get anything.
171 millimetres of rain fell at Springbrook overnight, almost 400 in 3 days. That's all washing into Hinds Dam, which was spilling before this weather system even arrived. Hinds is now at 109% capacity, the spillway almost 2 metres underwater.
I love the sound of the water coming down and it's lovely and fresh.
Quite unlike the beaches in Queensland's tourist capital, lifeguards closed them all first thing this morning.
The water clarity, you just can't see it, just so dirty and dark.
Waves of more than 2 metres are crashing onto beaches, mixing the flood runoff into a mess of foam. The shoreline at Snapper Rocks has been buried.
I've never seen anything like it.
What's
it's just
it feel like,
nice and fluffy and soft.
The foam has covered debris being washed out from coastal creeks and rivers.
Like when you take a step, you kick your toe on a rock or something and it hurts.
Wave heights will continue to build overnight and the wind strength too. And with flood runoff still to make its way down the rivers, lifeguards expect beaches will be closed again tomorrow. Anything but a surfer's paradise. On the Gold Coast, Amanda Abate, 7 News.
Yes, well, let's bring in our coastal expert, Paul Burt. Now, Bert, he looks pretty wild there at the Gold Coast Seaway.
Yeah, it certainly is at the moment, Maxie. Look, we pretty much dodged a bullet today, but I can tell you now the wind gusts have really started to pick up in the last half an hour. The barrier north of Ormo to Bean Lee that really held that system away from the Gold Coast has since been broken. Now that system is moving down onto the Gold Coast as we are standing here at the Southport Seaway. The waves behind me are crashing through. Coastal bars will be closed over the next 24 to 48 hour period, along with all Gold Coast beaches during that time. Wave recording stations starting to build now as well, 2.5 up to 4.5 metres, and they're anchored a couple of kilometres offshore. But checking out the satellite, we are seeing that system again approaching on the Gold Coast. It looks as though we're in for a bit of a wild night down here tonight, Max.
All right, thanks for that, Bertie. So, Tony Auden, how much more rain can we expect?
Well, Max, the flooding risk is now a question of how much, how long it falls for, and where it falls. Now, here is the upper low driving those humid northeast winds feeding into this rain system. It's expected to stay inland until finally pushing offshore late on Sunday. Until that happens, we have all of those ingredients for more heavy rain across the southeast. That's plenty of time to accumulate further widespread falls of at least 200 to 300 millimetres and pockets of much heavier rain again. The forecast models have chopped and changed on this, but they still agree and they keep pushing this rain further inland. The Lockyer Creek and Bremer River catchments, which feed into the Brisbane River and aren't protected by Wivenhoe Dam, this rain could worsen the current flood forecast for Ipswich and Brisbane. Where the rain falls tomorrow will be critical to how this event plays out. Sharon, I'll be back soon with the latest.